Good morning. Can I still be a little bit, yeah? Wow. Today's sermon, that was kind of a strange scripture. I'm sure the adults are like, what is she going to say about that? Well, the title of my sermon today is God Loves You, period, period. Do you know what we mean when we say something like that? God loves you, period. End of sentence. That's all I have to say, right? That's it. There's no limitations to that. There's nothing to add to it. God loves us, period. And that's all God was really saying in the scripture by the prophet Hosea. He wanted, back in the Old Testament times, the nation of Israel to know that no matter what, no matter what they did, no matter how they might have broken the rules sometimes and not done what God asked them to do, he loves them. Period, end of sentence. Can you name me somebody that you know loves you? Period. Dad? Mom? Absolutely. And that's one of the most important. You love her? She loves you? You're pointing, you love each other? Period. That is awesome. That is so awesome. Because family is just everything. We have to go through the world. You know, there are a lot of little girls and boys who don't know that somebody really loves them, period. And I just want you both to know that God loves you. You might break the rules sometimes. You might get in trouble at home. You might even have to get time out at home. But just like mom and dad loves you, period, God loves you, period. And because you believe in him and trust him, he's going to help you always know that and remember that. So, all I really wanted to say today was to remind you that mom and dad love you, period. God loves you, period. Your church loves you, period. There's simply nothing that you can ever do to make God not love you. Do you believe that? God is just that good and he's that big. There is nothing that you can ever do, no matter how bad you are, and what kind of mistakes you make, God always loves you. Period. The end. That's all I have to say. Time for Sunday school.